Can you imagine Scott Steiner and Rick Steiner on the opposing teams now?
Well, that's what it's all about, Slamboree. When you talk about lethal lottery and things like that happen and thrown together, I mean, game plans go out the window. But you have to win to advance. Oh, my goodness gracious. To advance. I guarantee you, man, are you gawking now?
The booty man still nursing that injury.
Pick your chin up off the floor.
That took him out of the... That took him out of the main event this past Monday on Nitro, going up against the Punisher, but he and Rick Steiner to go up against Scott Steiner and the Pitbull Craig Pittman. One of the matches just announced, just drawn by Mean Gene Okerlund at random, and the Booty Man seems to be in pretty good shape here.
Yeah, and going back to that thing about Steiner, that's what makes this pay-per-view so unique. Yeah, Booty Man coming back strong, brother. I guarantee you. I thought he really had a serious neck injury, which he did, but being able to come back is what it's all about in this great sport. With a big boy, play at WCW.
High knee, 1, 2, 3, it's over.
High knee.
You talking about looking sensational now.
Talking about high knee. He gave him the high knee.
Boy, did he ever. All right, I'm going to be talking to the Booty Man and the Booty Babe here, Dream, so you take it away.
Well, all right, you see the great victory right there and a big high knee, if you will. But right now, I'm just find out what the Booty Man got to say. Let's go down to the Silver Tongue. Tony Schiavone standing by with the Booty Man.
All right, Dream, we are here with the Booty Man and Kimberly the Booty Babe. And it wasn't too long ago right here on this program, attacked by Kevin Sullivan, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. And how about Hulk Hogan coming to the honor of Kimberly the Booty Babe this past Monday?
Well, you can't expect nothing less than the Hulkster to stand up and be the man that he is. That's why he is the Hulkster. And he rose to the occasion. He was like a man possessed. He took it to him. He did what he had to do. And everybody knew that he would. Especially me, Tony Schiavone. Especially after he saw what Kevin Sullivan did. Tried to take me out once and for all. Tried to drop me on my head. Break my neck. It ain't gonna happen, brother. The neck's too strong. And too much strain and too much stress. Too many bottoms.
And how about it, Kimberly? Of course, Hulk Hogan standing tall for you this past Monday.
Boy, Tony, am I glad he stepped up to the plate to defend my honor last Monday. I'll tell you what, I've always said any friend of the Booty Man's is a friend of mine, but I owe him an extra special debt of gratitude for helping me out.
All right, let's talk now about Slamboree, the Lethal Lottery drawn. You and Rick Steiner will be tag team partners. You could be the last man standing. You could go into the next pay-per-view going up against the WCW World Champion.
Well, that's absolutely right. Rick Steiner, world-class athlete, world-class wrestler, is my partner. The name of the game is being the last man standing, and that's going to be the Booty Man to get the WCW Championship around his waist. Woo, yeah!
All right, the Booty Man and the Booty Babe, Kimberly, back right after this.
Can one of you quench my thirst for the divine conflict, the supreme struggle? Or will your planet be doomed to the same fate?
More Saturday night. I'm sure you recall the public display of affection last week of this program by Ric Flair kissing the hand, arm, and shoulder of Miss Elizabeth. Now, if that happened on television, what's going on behind closed doors? How does all of this really affect the Macho Man Randy Savage? He's sideways. I've talked privately to all parties involved in this horrid love-hate triangle, and I will chronicle the affairs privately of the Nature Boy Elizabeth and her ex, Randy Savage. You're not going to believe the inside skinny. Call me on the hotline tonight until midnight at 1-900-909-9900. Kids, really get your parents' permission on this one. 1-900-909-9900. Call right now. 6:05 tomorrow night here on PBS. Join Bobby the Brain Heenan and myself for the main event. Here's a great one, a feature about BK Wall Street and Sergeant Craig Pitbull Pittman. A couple of fellas that really profess a great amateur background. That's tomorrow night, 6:05. Right now, let's get you back to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following special rematch is a no disqualification contest. Set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanying to the ring by Tony Dick Slater.
Dream, here's a return match. No disqualification last week, a disqualification of the championship committee this week. Signed the return match. We look forward to see what's going to happen here.
Well, I'll tell you what, down back in the hallway, I tried to get a take on this situation. And Gunnar Parker running around telling Dick Slater, I am the big rooster. I'm going to take care of her. I'm going to put the leg lock on her. And Slater trying to tell him that, hey, this girl's close to ragtagging him.
With that in mind, we anticipate a wild one as we go back to David Pinzer.
From Tampa Bay, Florida, she is Madusa!
Here comes Madusa! Speaking of wild, we heard the comments earlier for the Macho Man, Randy Savage. He is still here, and Ric Flair later on will be coming out. And here we go, Madusa, Colonel Parker, one more time. Oh, he will stay away from her. Look at this.
Yeah. She got him round. Look at him. Look at that big old rooster now, hiding behind that little hen. I guarantee Medusa's ready to do some crazy stuff with it. And she can deal out punishment and take it.
One of the top lady wrestlers in the world, Medusa.
Slater need to get down from there. Boy, the Macho Man Randy Savage, edgy ain't a word. You know
what
I mean?
Oh, look at this.
What, he got him by the hair? He need her.
He need her
right in the belly welly, right in that open spot for people listening on radio. She got a two-piece on.
A pickup. And Parker choking Medusa.
Drops a man.
Man,
sweetheart. God love her. She needs to get up and kick him right in the high knee.
You're not kidding, buddy.
I'm telling you.
Out to the midsection.
Wow. Oh, no, man. Hey, no, ref. Oh, no.
Pile driver, maybe?
Kick him leg. Get down and get him up.
Trying to pick him up.
Oh, yes.
Back body drop. How about that?
All right. Get wild with him, baby. Go on, girl.
She's got him up. She slammed him down.
Get loose, girl. Go on, girl.
She slammed him down. Colonel Parker on the outside.
He's left. He's retreated.
Look at him. He's falling all over himself.
Oh, yeah. It's Slater. Oh, man. I
He's leaving.
No, man.
He's and the referee is counting. What a slam by that lady. And Parker's gone. It's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match as a result of the count-out, Madusa.
Parker runs away. He is still
running.
And she's got his jacket.
He has left the building. Oh, man. Rip it up. Put your little fit on it, you know what I mean? A little feet, you put your fit.
Wiping her feet on the jacket. Back with more on Saturday night after this.
Man.
This coming Monday on Nitro, Guerrero, you're going to find out what the Quibbler is all about.